Go ahead, Cambridge, Iowa.
This is Cambridge, Iowa, population 600, 30 miles north of Des Moines. In Cambridge, the whole town's talking. At the garage, Larry Gardner says, if we lost our high school, I'd lose my business. On the steps of the Methodist Church, Reverend Rex says, the high school keeps our town alive. In Samper's Barbershop, John Dyer is saying, the high school is losing too many pupils. What are we going to do? January 3rd, 1952, to Cambridge, Iowa, a town with a problem, comes television to catch the face and voice of America itself.
WOI-TV presents The Whole Town's Talking. Here in Cambridge, Iowa, 12 Americans vote on an issue which may mean life or death for their town.
This is the Cambridge School. In 1938, there were 80 pupils in the high school. In 1945, there were 55. Today, there are 46. How small can this high school get and still be a good school? That is the problem. In 28 minutes, before the eyes of their children, in this classroom, their neighbors watching at home, and the entire 250,000 viewing audience of WOI-TV, these 12 citizens of Cambridge will make a symbolic decision for their town on how the high school problem should be solved. Guiding them for the whole town's talking will be Ralph Imes, clergyman from Eldora, Iowa. And here on the whole town's talking vote board are the alternatives these people must face. The town can stay put, keep the high school and try to improve it. It can close the high school and send the children to other schools and pay tuition. It can consolidate, try to absorb the independent rural districts in its township around it. Or it can reorganize, join together with neighboring towns to form a single large school district, which might mean a better school. But would that school be in Cambridge? And if not, would Cambridge die? This afternoon, before free discussion and argument, a secret ballot was taken by these 12 on this issue, and it was 3 to stay put, 8 to consolidate, 1 to reorganize. At the end of this program, to inspire their whole town to take official, democratic steps leading to the solution of Cambridge's school problem, they will vote again. They will press these buttons on their desks, which will light up their choice on the vote board. But choosing the right button to press is not going to be easy for a man like John Dyer here. He and his wife raised their son in Cambridge and saw him go on to become a college professor. John Dyer is the rural postman now, alone most of the time out on his route. A rural postman never loses touch with people. Mr. Dyer gets to talking with them. He hears about other towns and other schools. He wonders if these children are getting all they should out of the Cambridge school. If these children, when they grow up, will be as well prepared as the graduates of other schools in other towns, like Cedar Rapids and Des Moines. John Dyer's been thinking about this problem, and now he's made up his mind. He loves his town and the old school and the kids. But for John Dyer, it's the kids that come first. He's found his answer. Now Larry Gardner. He looks at this problem another way. Larry was born in Cambridge, and he depends on it for a living. With his father and brother, he runs a busy, prosperous garage, servicing the cars and farm equipment of his neighbors. Larry's boy Richard is in the second grade at the Cambridge school. And Ronnie is 4. He'll be going to the Cambridge school soon. A man feels proud of 2 fine youngsters like these. He wants them to have the best education they can get. But Larry and Mrs. Gardner want their town, too. They believe, as the school goes, so goes Cambridge. Larry's found his answer, a different one from John Dyer's. Sitting here, taking part in the discussion, Larry's thinking of his kids, his garage, and what would happen if Cambridge lost its school.
What would really happen if Cambridge lost its school?
Well, Ralph, it would tear the very heart right out of our community.
That's pretty rough talk, isn't it? Who'd do a thing like that?
Well, there are certain people in the state that are trying to force this thing of reorganization down our throats. And I don't believe that we want it in our community. We're not ready for it. There's several reasons why that we should stay and hold our school.
You think there's really some life in the old town yet?
Yes,
huh?
We have our growing businesses. We have a chart here showing a few reasons why we should stay put. The solution, or my proposal to this, is that we have two main railroads going through our town. This is also another reason. Some people have referred to our town as a whistle stop. Our town really isn't a whistle stop. We have two main railroads running through it, and that gives us two whistles, and as long as those whistles are blowing, we'll keep fighting for our town. The black area indicated here is the town of Cambridge. The shaded area shows the independent district of Cambridge. District number 7, or Union number 7, is the district south of town that is coming into Cambridge with their pupils. The area surrounding it is independent districts. The numbers indicate each one.
Well, just what would you do then if you're going to propose a plan to solve this problem?
My proposal is that we consolidate the remaining independent districts in Union Township. By consolidation, we would gain seven students in district number 2. We would gain 3 in district number 5. We would gain 3 high school students in 5, 3 in 9, 1 in 6, and 2 in number 1. Now this only represents the high school students that we would get in our high school. We would also get a large amount of elementary pupils.
I know, that's all right, Larry, but what about these people out here? What are they going to say about that? Are they going to like that?
Well, the natural trend for the people in this community is to do their business or trade in Cambridge. To back my statement up here, I have an overlay showing the trade area that Cambridge takes in.
Well, you look like a government bureau with all these charts. What does that thing mean? You can't prove that to me that way.
Well, this is a survey taken by the county superintendent's office. It represents natural trade area that comes to Cambridge. These people already trade in Cambridge, and it's a natural situation. The consolidated districts all lie approximately in those bounds, and it goes out even further than that.
Well, when you get it out big like that, are you going to have enough money for it?
Well, by making a larger tax base out of it, it would lighten the load on the independent district here in town. It would not raise the tax levy on these outlying farms, and it would give us a better school for the taxpayer's dollar.
You really think you can save the town that way? Is that it?
Well, that's the solution to, I think, to our problem. And I want to remind the folks here that when they push that button tonight, you have something at stake. You have your town, your school. You want the best for your money, the most for your money in your school. So when you vote, push that button for consolidation.
He's a little too big for me to answer this all alone. He's about the same size this way, but a little bigger this way. John, you know these people out in this area that come into Cambridge and make it a community. You think Larry's right when he says if you lose your school, it'll tear the heart out of your community?
I think he's absolutely wrong.